Hello and welcome to Motoroids. And what we have right now with us is the all new BMW 520d 7th generation. And this car has benefited a lot from its bigger brother, the 7 series, and it packs in a lot of technologies that the flagship BMW model has. And to start off, this has this remote control key which you can use to remotely start the engine, change the settings inside and move this car like an RC car fore and aft to park it in the garage. We have already demonstrated how to use this key, and you can see the demonstration on the 7 series in the link above. So we have been driving this car for more than 100 kilometers now, and this, as we told you before, is the 2-liter diesel version. This is the 520D, and the power output here is 190 HP with 400 Nm of torque. And while we really appreciate the steering because it's very feelsome, I think over the previous generation, the feel in the steering is back with this one, especially in the sport mode. It just has the right weight, and the feel from the road, you can really feel the surface of the road, and it eggs you on to, you know, drive it faster, engages you. But in terms of power delivery, I think that the right engine choice for this kind of a sporty car is the 3-liter diesel, which is more powerful and suits itself very well to the character of this car. The 2-liter diesel is very linear, revs all the way to its 5000 RPM redline, but it leaves you a little bit wanting for a bit more power, especially because this is a very big car and it's got some weight as well. So we really think that the 2-liter diesel, although very efficient, very practical, very smooth, and complemented very well by the 8-speed transmission, for out-and-out sport purposes, if you really enjoy driving, falls a little bit short in terms of the fun factor. This car comes with the usual modes, which are Sport, Comfort and Eco Pro. And these modes work exactly the way they worked before, but a new inclusion is this Adaptive mode, which tries to sense your driving style, the road surface, the speed, the steering angle and a lot of other parameters, and tries to configure everything, including transmission, the steering, the damping and everything, to suit the scenario that it is in. And we tried it while we were driving uphill in a very sporty fashion. I personally believe that it left me wanting for a bit more action as compared to the sport mode, which felt a bit more satisfying. So yeah, it tries to suit your driving style and the road conditions, but to match a specific mode perfectly is probably something that it doesn't do to perfection. What I also like about this car is the way it soaks up all the undulations on the road. It's very well damped, and apart from the sport mode where there is a fair bit of vertical movement at the rear, my colleagues have complained a little bit on rough surfaces. The comfort is nothing to complain about, absolutely no complaints whatsoever. So if you're going to travel with your family in comfort mode, there should not be anything to complain about, and you put it to sport mode and it would be stiff enough to give you a big wide grin on your face. So we'll start off with the design. And for the 7th generation car, the front has changed quite a lot. It's flatter, more muscular, and the signature LED rings are a bit more square. They are also merging neatly into the BMW kidney grille. Talking of the grille, this car benefits from another 7 series technology, which is the louvers on the grille. And as the car is started, you'd see that these louvers inside the grille will open up to let some air in, but when it's closed, they shut. And this essentially helps the car reduce its coefficient of drag and improve the performance and efficiency. To me personally, the front is very squat, very muscular, very angular, oozes a lot of presence and power. So in my personal opinion, I think that the new 5 series in its 7th generation looks more angular, more squat. But to leave an impression in the mind which stays, maybe a bit more could have been done with the lights or with some other cuts and creases. Anyway, we'll move on to the side, and this one is the luxury line variant. This is the 520D. This is available in 3 trims, the new 5 series in India. What we have is the 520D in the luxury line variant. You have a sport line variant with the 2-liter diesel, and then you finally have the 3-liter diesel, which is M Sport and which is the top of the line performance edition. This car is more towards the luxurious taste, trimmed with chrome and more on the subtle side. The sport line has a few sporty elements on the outside and on the inside, but the changes are very few, and the features are more or less the same. On the side, the wheels are 18 inches and they are shod with Pirelli rubber. And one interesting bit that you have here is this outlet, which essentially lets the air which is getting thrown out from the wheel area. You get chrome lined door handles on the luxury line frame. There's this chrome lining around the greenhouse area, and you obviously have this Hofmeister's kink. On the side, one very striking thing is the shoulder line, when it moves from the front, from the fenders, it splits in two. And that's a different kind of treatment that BMW has given to this 5 Series, and is quite a departure from what the shoulder line of the previous car was. At the back, the design theme of the front has been carried over, and it's lit by LEDs, and they look rather nice, very flat, gives the car a very wide stance, very nice sporty stance. And this has been known to be a sporty car, which is a business sedan with sporty intentions, and it reflects what it's meant to do rather well. The two exhausts at the rear further accentuate the fact that this car is oriented towards performance. And this chrome line on the rear bumper signifies that this is a luxury line variant. Inside the boot, the space is not very generous, but space for a small weekend, not too much, not too generous. As compared to the E-Class and the A6, the space is rather scarce here. However, this time BMW has provided a space saver spare, which is really, really important in Indian conditions. Though this car comes with run flat tires, but having a spare is very, very important, and we really appreciate that they've taken the pains to go ahead and provide a spare, which is very essential. Inside the cabin, the ergonomics remain the same. The layout for the buttons and everything, the knobs, is copybook BMW, because they have researched a lot on the ergonomics. Everything falls to the hand very, very nicely, and the center console is slightly tilted towards the driver to make things easy. However, there are a lot of changes. Modern bits like touch controls for AC panel and some menu items have been provided on the central floating screen, which is rather big and is touch enabled. Now, this screen also benefits from the latest technology introduced on the 7 Series, which is gesture control. And we have demonstrated properly as to what gesture control is. You can use five gestures, wherein you can use this gesture, or this gesture, this, and these volume gestures to control a lot of things on the screen, which include changing stations or tracks, increasing or decreasing volume, and accepting or not accepting a call. Another important thing about the new screen is that it's, as we said, touch enabled. However, it's more usable, we think, because you don't really need to have to necessarily go to the iDrive controller to control the elements on the screen, which is great. And you can just get inside any menu and choose whatever you want. So that's great convenience, and is the top of the line infotainment system provided by BMW on any of its models. Apart from that, the instrument console also gets a makeover. It's fully digital now, and as you can see, on the left you have the speedo, and on the right you have the taco. However, when you want to change the mode, you can do that by using this button. And this is somewhat similar to the Audi virtual cockpit, although not as extensive, but it's very, very information rich and can be totally customized using the iDrive through the settings. Now, the most important thing about the BMWs, it's the steering wheel. You want a BMW to drive, and BMWs are known as the ultimate driving machines. The steering here is very chunky and just the right size, great to hold, and we found it very, very nice on the road. It's very feelsome, very, very engaging. I think the steering feel and the overall involvement that it invokes has gone a level up with the new generation, so that gets a great thumbs up from us. Apart from that, here on the floating panel you have some new inclusions. As you can see, we have a phone lying here, and it's charging right now, so wireless charging has been introduced. Apart from that, there is space under the central armrest. There's a wallet lying here. You can put a couple of phones, so that's a usable bit. You have two cup holders right here, and you also have a power outlet as well as a cigarette lighter. There is another power outlet here, as well as a USB in socket. The quality of materials on the dashboard is impeccable as ever. It's built and finished exquisitely. The materials like these wood inserts, these aluminum inlays, piano black, everything is crafted to perfection. Even the leather, the brown leather that we have here is of a very, very fine quality. The seats are as comfortable as they always are with BMW. Very comfortable seats. You can go on long drives without having any second thoughts. In terms of storage in the door, you have space for a full 1 liter water bottle and then some space on the side. The seats on both the sides obviously are electrically adjustable and they have memory function as well. You can set two settings and save them in the memory. And on the passenger side also they are electrically adjustable. Audio is provided through Harman Kardon system, which is very good, although on the top of the volume at the very high levels there is some kind of distortion that can be felt. But from mid to higher mid range there is no problem at all, and the quality is not something that we can complain of. In addition to that, you also get a sunroof, although not panoramic, but the sunroof is still here. In case you don't want to use the touchscreen central panel, you can always use the iDrive, which comes with very intuitive controls as well as a trackpad for character recognition, and you can fill in a lot of input fields using the trackpad. So this is one of the most refined infotainment input systems which are there, and we really appreciate BMW for the long way that they've come in refining and making this system one of the most intuitive on any car across the world. With the new 5 series, you also get ambient lighting, and the colors that you can choose from are as many as the new 7 series, and that's a great feature to have inside the cabin. So that was the story up front, and we'll go to the back seat and see what the state of affairs is there. The moment you sit in the back seat, you feel a special feeling of being cosseted. The back seats are very comfortable, you feel very well wrapped around, and there's a nice feeling sitting in these seats. They're very ergonomically designed, and I really like the feeling of being in this seat here. The legroom here may not be class leading, but it's sufficient, more than sufficient, and there's no reason for me to complain. On the side, on the door panel, if you see, there's this big fat 1 liter Bailey's water bottle which fits inside the door panel very easily. I have these manual blinds for those sunny days, and for the quarter panel window as well. And this motor operated rear blinds is also there, which can be controlled via a button up front. Apart from that, the car also gets a 4-zone climate control, which is great from the Indian weather perspective. The armrest provides a lot of support, so it's good. And there are two cup holders integrated into the armrest. There is no dearth of headroom here. Even people who are taller than 6 foot would not have any problem whatsoever. Ample thigh support, so long journeys as a backbencher in this car is not going to be a concern for you, as long as there are only 4 passengers in the car, because there's a big transmission tunnel here, and there's not space for a third person to sit, because he'll have to take his two legs on the two sides of the transmission tunnel, and that won't be very comfortable for medium to long journeys. Overall, a great place to be, and although this is not class leading in terms of space, I don't really have any qualms about the comfort and the space here. But while being driven in comfort mode, the car's suspension, the adaptive dampers, they soak the undulations and the bumps very, very well. However, this is a sportily oriented car, and in sport mode, you may feel a bit of vertical movement and a bit of harshness, but you have to be ready for that if you are going to drive a 5 series, which has always been known for its taut handling and the thrill-monging kind of a character that it has. So that was our quick understanding of the new BMW 5 Series. And at this point in time, the new E-Class and the 5 Series are the latest products in the segment. The new A6 is due, and the current A6 is at the end of its production cycle. This car is actually retailing for a very good price. This ranges from 52 lakh rupees to 64 lakh rupees. And this one, the luxury line variant, is retailing for 55 lakh rupees, which is a very good price for the segment. However, this car is oriented more towards driving. So if you're someone who wants a family car while you also want to drive, this is the one you go for. But if you are someone who wants to focus primarily on the backseat comfort, then the new E-Class LWB aces it in terms of the leg space and creature comforts. So for driving this one and for the people who are chauffeur driven, we would suggest the E-Class. However, if you really want to drive, the 530D M-Sport is the car which packs all the power, and we are going to come back to you with a review of that version as well very soon. Thanks a lot for watching. If you liked the video, do like, share and subscribe to the channel, and we'll be coming back to you with a lot more action. This is Amit Changani signing off.